I'm just about to get in the car and start my journey to France. I'm going to spend the day trying to find my great Uncle Harry's war grave. My Uncle Harry was killed in the Battle of the Somme in 1916. He was my granddad's brother, that's my father's uncle. And as a child, I can remember him being spoken about with great affection. So, it's going to be quite an emotional day, I think, but a day I'm very much looking forward to. Well, I'm in France, I've just stopped, and I've been looking on my phone, and thanks to the Commonwealth War Graves Commission and their website, I can pinpoint the exact spot of Harry's grave. So, the plan is now to drive to the grave, which is near Arras. I think about my granddad, Jack, and my dad, who was also Jack, and my great grandparents, Thomas and Elizabeth. I never knew them, but my dad always used to say what a lovely, kind woman Elizabeth was. And I kind of just feel something of her heartache. And I know that my granddad would have loved to have come here, and so would my dad, but we didn't actually find out where the grave was until the advent of the internet. So here I am at my journey's end. This is the grave of my great Uncle Harry, 3472 Lance Corporal H. Hawes, Lincolnshire Regiment, died the 14th of October 1916. But the most amazing thing is this inscription. He lies with England's heroes in the watchful care of God. And I'm struck by how poetic it is, especially compared to some of the other inscriptions. Many of the stones don't have any sort of inscription like that. And all of a sudden I'm struck with the fact that I could use these words in the Great War Symphony. They'd be perfect for my elegy, the third movement, which takes as its basis August 1916 to August 1917. And this just fits perfectly in that time frame. This great poetic phrase. And of course, my personal connection with the First World War. Well, I'm so pleased to have been able to find Great Uncle Harry's final resting place. Somehow it makes the harsh reality of the war much more tangible for me. And of course, I'm so pleased that I can commemorate Harry in the Great War Symphony by using the words of his epitaph in the work as a thank you and act of remembrance for the ultimate sacrifice he and so many others like him made for our country.